So we said that in x86-64, there's a special flags register for these condition codes. And there are four main condition codes that we care about. So there's the carry flag, which indicates that the last operation resulted in either a carry out or a borrow in. So in other words, this is going to indicate overflow for unsigned arithmetic. There's a zero flag, which indicates that the last operation resulted in a zero. There's a sign flag, indicating that the last operation resulted in a negative value. So this would assume that the value is a signed value, so we can just check the first bit. And then the overflow flag, which indicates that the last operation caused a 2's complement overflow, either positive or negative. There are also a bunch of flags that we won't use, although the textbook talks about a couple of these. So there's the parity flag, the adjust flag, the interrupt flag, and these are useful in some contexts, but we're not going to talk about them extensively in this course. If you are working through assembly code in a debugger and would like to take a look at these flags, you can just print eflags, or you can display them every time you run with the display command. All right, so in addition, the carry flag is set if an addition requires a carry out of the most significant bit. So it's the extra bit that's necessary to represent the result. So here we did not have a carry out. We were able to represent the answer exactly here, so there was no carry. Here, if you work this through, you'll find that you need to carry a value out. And so what this means is that in unsigned arithmetic, this addition overflowed. And so the carry flag would be set here. Similarly, we set the carry or the, it's called the borrow flag. It's the same flag, but it's called the borrow flag if we were doing a subtraction. And that's set if a subtraction requires a borrow into the most significant bit. So for this first one, we are able to do this subtraction without having to borrow into the most significant bit. So the carry flag would be zero. Down here, we don't have enough here in order to actually do this operation, and so we would have to borrow in. What's really happening here, right, is that the answer is going to be a negative number if we interpret this using a using 2's complement. But in any case, this has also been an unsigned overflow, right? And so the carry flag would be set in this case as well. So in general, the carry flag indicates unsigned overflow, and the overflow flag indicates 2's complement or signed overflow. There are also a couple of special instructions, like we mentioned earlier, that are generally only performed just to set the condition codes. So there's CMP and there's test. So CMP or compare compares two values. Under the hood, it actually does a subtraction, which is will become important later on this semester. Also note the reversed ordering. This is a super confusing aspect of this instruction. It basically subtracts the first argument from the second argument. And so if you're kind of reading this, you would tend to read this in reverse, right? So if this were a subtract, it would be subtract EAX from ECX, right? And so if we're going to compare it, it's really kind of comparing ECX to EAX. Note that this is type agnostic, so it doesn't really matter whether these are signed or unsigned numbers. It's going to do the same operation regardless. And it's going to set all of the flags regardless of, you know, whether it was actually signed data or not. So this is why it's important for you to do the correct jump instruction, and we'll see all the jump instructions here in just a minute. Another important thing to notice about the compare is that it doesn't actually change either operand. So this is kind of a non-destructive comparison. There's also a test, which we can often use to check for non-zero values. It's actually just an AND that is also non-destructive. So it computes arg2 and arg1, so the second operand and the first operand. And again, it sets the carry and the overflow flags to zero, and then it sets the zero and the sign flags appropriately. But it doesn't change either operand. So here we can sort of check the low order bits of EDX, for instance. So this will preserve the low order 16 bits of EDX, and it will set the flags according to the value of those 16 bits. Okay, so here's a couple of questions that we'll go through just to test your understanding, and then the lab will do more of this. Again, feel free to try these. So you have all the tools you need to put these in as assembly code instructions and to run them in GDB so that you can see what flags are actually set. And I would encourage you to test these yourself if you're unsure what's going to happen. So here's the first one. So suppose that REX is 5 and RBX is 10. So what flags are going to be set after this comparison? So if you took a minute to think about that, so we're subtracting RBX and RAX, so we're doing 10 minus 5. That's going to give us 5 back. We didn't have to carry, so we didn't have to borrow in order to do that, so the carry flag will not be set. The result is not 0, so the 0 flag will not be set, and the result is not negative, so the sign flag will not be set. So the answer here is none. Okay, so here's the next question, and very subtle difference. I just flipped the order of these two operations. So rather than subtracting RAX from RBX, this is subtracting RBX from RAX. So now we don't have enough value here in order to do the subtraction, right? So we're going to have to borrow in, and so that means that the carry flag is going to be set. The result is still not going to be 0. It's going to be a very large unsigned number that is going to be, if interpreted in 2's complement, is actually negative 5. So the 0 flag is not going to be set, but it is a negative number. That sign bit is going to be set, so the sign flag will be set. So it'll be CF and SF in this case. And then finally, test REX and RBX. So take a minute and see if you can figure out which flags are going to be set there. So we said that the test instruction always sets the carry flag to 0, so that'll be set to 0. And then for the other ones, you may need to think about what these are in binary. So 5 is 101 in binary, and then 10 is 1010 in binary. So if you line those up and you do the binary AND, you'll find that the result is actually 0. So the 0 flag will be set, but the sign flag will not be set.